So start with a short presentation, and definitely when the time arises, get into the detailing of it. That is the strategy number 5. The strategy 6, perfect your sales pitch. Make it exciting. So we'll see how do we make the sales pitch ahead once we proceed. So it's strategy number 6 is perfect your sales pitch. Make it exciting to the end user. Highlight prospects' challenges, present your solution, and then call to action. Strategy 7, the lucky 7x. Other day, because he was asking me why your everything is 7-7. So I do believe in 7. I always followed 7 since my childhood. And 7, you know, anything, you know, ending with 7, that somehow becomes lucky for me. I don't know how true it is, but somehow it works. So I kept 7 as a benchmarking, and I tried to do most of the things when it's under 7. Yeah, so use the PASS framework. PASS framework is your problem, agitation, and the solution. So the problem, you're identifying, you clearly state the problem your product solves for prospects. Agitate, highlight how dangerous the problem is and remind the prospects about all the negative implications it can have. So tell your client that, oh, if you have not bought, you don't know what you have missed. Or if you're not buying it right now, you do not know. You have no idea what you're going to lose it. So just help him, hesitate it. Tell him the consequences of not buying your product and the services at that. Once you have found the problem and give them the solution. So solution, you know that through your product and the services, position your product as the solution to their specific problem. Now, strategy 8, connect with the key decision maker, the KDM, the big boss who signs the check, who says yes to it, right? Otherwise, there are many people who are support to the KDM. Sometimes it is very difficult for a salesperson to reach out to a key decision maker, and they reach to the first step is a booker who is just books, and probably his conversation or his product information may not reach to the man, the KDM, the prospect, because so we will see in details how it worked. So there are influencers for a gatekeeper, user, initiator, approver, decider, and then the buyer. So to get to the main person, the strategic sales says that to also you get in touch with these people. Many a time salespeople make a mistake just going to one person in a corporate, and they feel that he is the only one who will give me the sale, who will write the check. No, you're mistaken. There is a finance controller, there is a person who is actually end user, there are influencers that take the product, or see in hotels many times happen. So if the time permits, I will get into the detailing when you have questions about it. But it's really good to know all these influencers and the prospect and corporate level, how it works. Am I communicating, everyone?